Okay. For this video, I'm going to show you how to personalize your website from your back office. So to get started, I'm going to share my screen. We're going to go here, and the first thing you need to do is log in. So I'm going to put in, oops, not now, this person's password. And you will want to save that password, but for now, we are in the back office. So the next thing you're going to want to do to personalize your website is come over here to the left and find where it says My Profile. Once you're in your profile, just verify that this information is correct, your address and whatever else you need to do, and then you can update your profile from the bottom here. But what we're going to be doing is working on the website information. So I'm going to click on this. And you can see that your website's URL currently is going to be www.myzaya.com/yourrepid. So what we want to do is we want to change this rep ID to a more recognizable name for your customers so that you can just tell them to go to myzaya.com/ whatever it is you want to make your website. So the way we do that is we're going to personalize this website. And you will see where it says my website name, one word only. And so for this rep, she wants her website name to be Tam Tam. And that's really all you have to do. I wouldn't worry about any of these Google Analytics or anything right now. If you scroll down, you'll be able to display your work phone number on your webbacks. It's going to be your website that your customers go to. So you can show them your phone number, your cell, your fax, address. I'm going to go ahead and check email and show picture and show your events. No need to show on locator, but this way when somebody comes to your back office, they can contact you through email, they can see who you are, and then they can search your events to see which event they want to look at. You can add a welcome message here, and I'll show you what that looks like in just a bit, but if you want to skip all this for now, you can do that. All you need to worry about is changing your website name to something that is recognizable for you and your customers, and then you can always come back and add a welcome message. So from there, we're going to hit update your site. And now that your site is updated, we are going to go to close. And the next thing you're going to want to do is upload a photo. So to do that, you click upload photo, and then I'm going to select where I want to upload my photos. Let me go here to my downloads. And I'm looking for a picture of Tam Tam. So let me see if I can find it real quick. Right here is the picture she wanted me to use. So I'm going to upload that. And once that's uploaded, you'll be able to see it right here, and then you can hit close. And then again, you'll want to update your profile. Notice right away that this did not change. It's got to do its thing. It's got to process before you'll see where your website URL has changed. Until that time, you still want to send them to 12779, your rep ID. But as soon as it kind of 24 hours or so does its thing, you can send them to your www.myzaya.com/tamtam. And that is it to update your profile. While we're in here, since this is the very first thing you're going to want to do set up, I'm just going to show you real quickly what the back office is about. So on this first page, you're going to see this is a brand new rep, and you're going to see that Tamara, I always kind of start on my website on the home page or right here, and this kind of keeps up with your numbers, and it will change throughout the month, and then at the end of every month, it's going to reset back to zero. So Tamara just got started. 145 from her starter kit is actually applied to her lifetime personal volume. This number will always accumulate, so right now it's 145, but every sale she makes will just accumulate here. And so the reason we want to look at that number is because when you get down in here, you'll have, when you're looking to look for different rank qualifications, your lifetime personal volume levels will be here. So that is the number that accumulates. Now, when you're looking to see how much you're going to make a month, or if you're looking to see how much sales you've done in a month, then you'll want to look at this section here. These are the numbers we set every month. So for your total group volume, if you are a rep and you have other reps under you, they're level ones, level twos, their sales will show up in here. And so those sales will accumulate right here. So this is this also will include your personal sales. So when you're talking about group volume, it includes anybody underneath you as well as your own numbers. On the qualified personal volume, this is how much you sold. So let's say you make you purchase something, but you use your 25% off discount from the back office. That will show up here. However, because you use 25%, it's not going to be a commissionable volume. So in order for it to be commissionable volume, you're going to have your sales at full retail price. So any sales you make to your customers will show up as commissionable personal volume. And I'm going to get into later how I make this work for myself so that I can accumulate a commissionable sale as well as my qualified personal volume. But typically, if all of your sales are done at retail price, then these two numbers will match. Anytime you make a sale from your back office using the 25% off, then it's going to represent that here. And then, of course, as you close parties throughout the month, it's going to keep up with how many parties you close throughout the month here. And again, all of this resets at the first of every month. If anybody happens to enroll under you as a team member, this number will grow here as well. So it just kind of helps you navigate your goals for the month. On this homepage, you'll also see we've got our summit coming up, and so they're just giving us our little challenges that we're doing for the month or for the next couple months. These are your volume by levels, and I'm going to get into rank qualifications and volumes by levels in another video. So I just wanted to kind of give you an idea of what the homepage is about and your profile. So for the other items here, I'm going to go ahead and end this video, and then I will start another video in just a bit on how to use these features.